that has nothing to do with what I was
talking about. Once again, you're talking about me.
So when you become president and you're in the Oval Office, you feel, okay, now I have to act presidential. And we lost track of what had gotten us there, and that was our ability to tell stories and relate to people. Now, in fairness, part of it was the world economy was collapsing, and I had two wars that I had to deal with, and so that'll make you kind of serious. And
two wars and a collapsing economy.
Yeah, it was a...
Welcome to the gig.
Right. Yeah. Where's
the handbook on that?
Well, I think people forget how bad things were. It turns out the economy was collapsing faster than it did during the Great Depression. The month I took office, we had lost 800,000 jobs just in that month. And one of the things I'm proudest about is the fact that within a year, we actually had the economy growing again. And within about a year and a half, we were actually adding jobs again instead of losing them. But look, there was a lot of pain at that time and a lot of anguish and a lot of stress. And there wasn't a good blueprint for how to do that.
Now, I fall prey to a cliche, which I believe I first heard from you. And it goes like this. My son in 20 years will say to me, wait a minute, you knew this was a problem, but you didn't do anything about it. And I apply that to all manner of circumstances in life and in the world. Are we safe from the same thing repeating itself?
There's some long-term trends that are still a problem. You still have growing inequality. The combination of technology and globalization, it means that there are entire industries and categories of jobs that are being eliminated. The costs of college, the costs of healthcare are still going up, although not as fast as they were when I came into office. And so in that environment, you know, if all the money is going to a handful of people at the top and they're investing in all kinds of stuff because they want to maximize their return, that's how you start getting bubbles. That's how you start getting an overheated financial system. The challenge that we still have to address is how do we make an economy in this globalized technological environment that's working for everybody?
To hear you describe this in a way that I can understand, it just makes me so happy you're still president, because
don't we all wish?
Let's just say there is a democracy, and the